In this video, we will protect our data with our DLP policy. In the first example, we want to prevent users from uploading any company data to FileShare websites or webmail. First, we create a general DLP policy. There are three modes to choose from: log only, log and notify, and log and block. We are going to choose the log and notify mode. We can also enable the shadow copy feature for this policy. There are a number of predefined templates. We are going to focus on uploading to FileShare websites and webmail. The DLP policy will be applied to the whole company. Users will now see a notification before uploading files to webmail or FileShare websites. In the second example, we have a company that wants to protect its sensitive data containing credit card numbers and IBANs. We have to create a data category and bond it to the DLP policy. Let's select credit card numbers and IBANs as the sensitive data in the category. There are also lots of other predefined algorithms and dictionaries to use. In addition, we can create custom expressions or upload custom dictionaries. We are going to adjust the threshold to 3 matches and leave the extensions as recommended. The policy type to choose is data, and it's applied to the previously created data category. This policy will be in log and block mode. The first matched policy from the list is applied. The more specific a policy is, the higher we need to place it. Consequently, general policies should be at the bottom. Let's see the DLP restrictions in action. When a user uploads an ordinary file to a FileShare website, they are notified and can choose to cancel the operation. Uploading a sensitive file containing IBANs or credit card numbers is blocked.